Jeez, Mr. Takes a Swing at Everybody. This is not her fault. She's a very nice girl and, more importantly, a fan. She even has a fan site dedicated to you.
Okay, this is part three. Yeah, I mean, I think we're
And
to
she was
there.
Very helpful when I was looking for you. This Seriously, Al, thirsty. What you were saying in the car, just listen to yourself. What, you shot a guy and his body just disappeared? When was the last time you slept? Are you high? Have you been drinking?
No! Look, Barry, I'm missing a week. And someone's got Alice.
Do you
and everything's
understand
just...
what it sounds like when you say stuff like that? Don't get me wrong. It's a good story. Could be a bestseller. But when you start confusing fiction with reality, you're buying yourself a ticket to the funny farm.
Right, wait here.
What wait here? Let's go. Dude, what the fuck? Is it me? Oh my god. Kind of like an easy one. I forgot.
I'd come here to rent a cabin where I could wait till midnight.
Rent a cabin? I couldn't figure out the compass. Oh my god, how, like, where am I? Like, is that me? In the compass? Okay. Probably not. I mean, something like that.
Easy there, boy. I'm almost done.
Hey, Rusty, right? You rent cabins.
Oh, Mr. Wake. I'd shake your hand, but mine are kind of full here. Actually, I'm sorry about this. Would you mind grabbing the registration form from the desk? It's just across from Bucktooth Charlie.
Okay, sure. What happened?
Crazy poachers. Max here got his foot caught in a trap. They're illegal to use here. Hell, you're not supposed to hunt within the park at all. But that doesn't stop some lowlifes. Well, at least Max is gonna be okay. He got lucky.
Okay.
Max is still groggy from the shot I gave him, and I'd rather not leave him alone just yet. The form's on the desk across from the mammoth skeleton.
Yeah, let's get it.
Seriously, Al, you can't just go and meet a kidnapper. Those situations always end up in disaster. You gotta talk to the cops.
She's my wife, and it's my call. Can we talk about this later?
No. This whole thing is... Listen, you hit your head. I mean, geez, Al, come on. You gotta understand how crazy all this sounds. If you're trying to pull a joke on me, freak me out, it's working. Ha ha, let's have a laugh on Barry. Well, you had me going there real funny, Al. You can quit it now.
Okay, whatever. Just a minute, 1 minute. Okay. Let's go. Let's go.
I think this is the form you wanted.
And here are the keys. Okay, you're all set, Mr. Wake. Glad to have you staying here.
Thanks. Can you tell me how to get to Lover's Peak?
Oh, sure. It's at the end of the nature trail. Mm-hmm. Just follow the paths, you'll get to it eventually. It's an easy walk. Nice spot, too. If you have any trouble finding it, just keep your eyes on the radio mast. It's right below that. Oh, and hey, if you take a walk in the woods, watch your step so you don't end up like Max. I guess I'm a little worried. We got a bunch of campers out there we haven't heard from. It's not like these people are on a schedule, but with the traps, well, you know, I just don't want any trouble.
Right, thanks.
Okay.
You're asking me to believe that you shot a dude who went poof into thin air, a guy who was bulletproof until you pointed a flashlight at him. You hear that from people who end up spending time in padded rooms, strapped to their beds, wearing white shirts with too long tangled up sleeves, and eating a healthy diet of pills. Al, you make cruel jokes about people who believe that kind of stuff. You're the skeptic. You gave me an hour-long lecture on homeopathy last month. What was it? If there's no proof, it's pure bullshit. Period.
Guess the laugh's on me then.
Al, come on! I mean, okay. Okay, maybe something weird happened to you, okay?
Well, thanks for the heartfelt vote of confidence.
All I'm saying is you gotta throw me a bone here, bestseller. What would you think if it was me? There's no way you should be going out at midnight with a gun.
No one asked you to come here, Barry. Either work with me on this or go straight back to New York. Your choice.
Let's go.
That's just crazy talk, Al. Al? Al? We should go to the sheriff or call the FBI.
Damn it, Barry. They'll kill her.
This is not a goddamn debate, Barry. I'm going to Lover's Peak. He said to come alone.
Okay then. I understand. You're my best friend, and I'm worried that you're not right in the head. Tell me what to do to help, and I'll do it.
You stay here, and if I'm not back by morning, call the cavalry.
Achoo! Achoo!
Just be careful with the natives, Al. These yokels are dangerous. Everybody hates a tourist, or it'll be deliverance all over again.
Achoo!
Bless you.
Oh, this place is trying to kill me. I'll bet there's mold in here, spores, poison ivy, God knows what. This is so not worth a 15% commission. Real funny, Al. Real funny. Ha-ha! Thank you! I'll just sit here in the dark till you come back. Or until I get eaten by a Gru.
Conspiracy or fed? Come back with... Oh my god, not again! Don't put it on that. Some books. Goddamn, why at night, bro?
I'll wait here, Al. I'll hold down the fort. I'll be with you in spirit every step of the way, Al. Locking the door now.
Cool, let's go.
I knew I should have gone to the cops. This wasn't the smartest thing I'd ever done, but I was still angry with Barry for trying to talk me out of it. These people had called me right in the sheriff's station. The cops wouldn't scare them, and they had Alice.
Welcome back to the show, folks. As promised, our very own Dr. Nelson has just parked his rear end in the studio. Doc, what's your Deerfest plan like? My plan? You make it sound a lot more organized than I ever seem to manage. No plan, really. Just taking the atmosphere. I'm getting a little too rickety to do much more than that, you know.
Oh, tell me about it. No sack race for us older gentlemen, huh?
Yes, exactly, Bat. But I'm gonna check out the parade, of course. And I'll be one of the pie contest judges, too.
Well, that takes a different kind of constitution.
Oh, yeah, it's my kind of exercise.
Now, Doc, seriously, you're in pretty good shape, though. You're the outdoors type. I know for a fact you're an avid fisherman.
That's right. Matter of fact, just caught a heck of a largemouth bass early this morning.
But you're not taking part in the fishing contest?
No, not this year. See, Pat, I'm just not that competitive anymore. Now I just like to take my time and enjoy the peace of it. It's no fun if I need to worry about what I'm catching, you know?
Considering your track record, the participants are probably pretty happy you feel that way.
Well, Pat, that's kind of you to say.
Spanish script. I haven't like properly read episode 1. Some pages are missing. I think they haven't picked up.
It's true what they say about the fall and the sudden stop at the end. I'd lain here in the snow while the lurid chain of scenes that had led me here kept playing in my head. A rerun of my own private snuff movie. A memory of my corpse. Alone at my own wake. Thinking in metaphors again. The femme fatale was gone. Only a sour taste remained of the kiss that killed me.
What the? Okay.
This was a late goodbye. 13 years after I'd gotten my revenge, it had finally caught up with me. It had been a long time to bear the pain. My blood painted the snow red, a gruesome slushy. Dissolved all the scattered painkillers and leisurely dripped down to the sewer, mingling with the bile of the city, becoming one with it. I can see them now, my wife and my baby. Honey, I'm home.
All right. I don't know. I can't understand. I'm dumb. Let's go. Can we get here like this? Lurwood National World Washington Mission Center. There's the light.
Crime and punishment. The cancer and cure of civilization. But some crimes are impossible to punish, especially in Night Springs. Tonight's episode, The Man in the Mirror.
He's inside, Agent. He's a weird one.
So, you're confessing to killing that guy, huh? Why?
Had it coming?
Yeah, but why would you do that? I mean, you're a nice guy. Normal. Took a kid to a soccer game. So how come at the game, you pick a guy and, quoting from the arresting officer's report here, assault the victim's head area repeatedly with the weapon of choice being a pair of bare fists? Wow, that sentence really flows, huh? Maybe you're not the literary type. Okay, so you mess him up. But why? Who was that guy? We couldn't ID him. Why would a guy like you do him like that?
I didn't like his face.
Well, you must have hated it, because you really went to town there. I mean, there's no way to tell what he looked like. No ID on him either.
That must be difficult.
But then we ran the fingerprints. Got a match. Your prints. Identical.
Huh, how about that?
Your son said you were wearing a white shirt when you took him to the game. But the white shirt is on the dead guy.
It's plenty red now.
You won't get away with this.
Do you really think that's in any way relevant to me? I had plenty of time to talk to my boy before the cops arrived, you know? He won't stop screaming, am I right? You think he's ever gonna be okay? I left my mark. Believe me.
You bastard.
What? You gonna shoot me? What's the point? I'm going to prison. You got me.
I don't understand any of this.
And you never will. Don't worry. Maybe you'll see me again, Agent. Maybe in the mirror.
Wake?
Oh, hell.
It happened just the way it was on that page. I found. Came true. It knew. So dark. It'll come back for me. You must. The lights. In the office. I have the key.
Okay, Rusty. Hang on. I'll be right back. Whatever did this couldn't be far. Rusty had found a page from the manuscript. It would help me understand what had happened.
Get the lights on. Oh my god, it's a bit of a monster.
The only way to make sure that Rusty was safe was to get the power running and the lights back on. Someone had destroyed the circuit breaker. There was no way to get the lights back on.
Rusty! Rusty!
The ground was covered with oily patches that looked like liquid darkness. Sized hole on the wall.
Please!
Don't feed the animals!
Fishing!
It's only permitted for those prisoners!
Who purchases a park?
Fishing.
License! Obey!
The park ranger's instructions!
At all times! Rusty? Rusty, no! Never! Two bears and wolves! Any other
wildlife
closer than
25 yards?
That's not really. Never leave your pet
unattended.
It is
against the law.
Let's go. cabin. Search for batteries and then.
Forget about it, Barry. It's just me going crazy.
Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. You're not crazy. I wish you were crazy, but you're not crazy. Ow, be careful.
Stay in the cabin. Don't open the door for anyone. I mean it.
Lover's Peak was at the far end of the nature trail.
Thank you. batteries, we can like focus. Okay, I'm back. At the exact time when they're attacking and we have to dodge. We don't have to rush for the UFO. It's like a sensor. They're taking our principal in Qatar and as you already know. Oh, we just came. Lover class, lover ship, whatever. Oh no. Where? My God, dude, what is this? Thank you. around, bro. You can't even duck. I guess. There you go.
Moving. More of them coming.
Get that?
That flashlight's kid stuff. The flares will keep the bastards away.
can see them too?
Hell, of course I see them. Come on, we gotta move.
Why?
Because that's the way the story goes.
Yeah, but...
Let's move!
I lost my gun back there.
Oh, I've got a gun. Just keep that light steady on him.
It took a moment, but then I recognized him. He'd been on the ferry when I first
arrived
in
Dallas.
He knew my name. We were headed in the direction of Lover's Peak. There was no way this was a coincidence. He was the kidnapper.
Come on, Wake! You better keep up. Hear that? It's them! Wake. Use the flares from the emergency box to hold them off while I get these boards off.
Give me the gun.
Yeah, no can do, Wake.
Are you kidding? Give me the gun!
No time for back. Pull them off, damn it! Just a little longer. Scare them off. Get some light on those bastards! That'll keep them off us! Just a little longer! I almost got it! Okay, it's open. Move it or move it! Right up these stairs, Wake. Use the flares from the emergency box to hold them off while I get these boards off.
Give me the gun.
Yeah, no can do.
Are you kidding? Give me the gun!
No time for back talk. Pull him off, damn it! Just a little longer. Scare him off. Get some light on those bastards. That'll keep them off us. Just a little longer, I almost got it! Okay, it's open. Move it or lose it. Oh, you feeling better now, Wake? All cozy and safe. Better get ready. They'll be on us soon.
Who are you? Bro, who are you? Where's my wife?
This is it, Wake. Our last stand. There's more flares here. Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming.
Give me the goddamn gun! They're coming!
That's not how this goes. Get with the program, Wake. Boy! Ah!
You're kidding me?
There's more flares here. Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming.
Give me the goddamn gun! They're coming!
That's not how this goes. Get with the program, Wake.
God, bro.
There's more flares here. Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming.
Give me the goddamn gun. They're coming.
That's not how this goes. Get with the program, Wake.
Give me the goddamn gun! They're coming!
That's not how this goes. Get with the program, Wake.
Thank you.
Are you kidding me?
There's more flares here. Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming.
Give me the goddamn gun! They're coming!
That's not how this goes. Get with the program, Wake.
Gonna work too, so basically...
There's more flares here! Get ready! We fight them as long as they keep coming!
Give me the goddamn gun! They're coming!
That's not how this goes! Get with the program, Wake!
God,
there's more flares here. Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming.
Give me the goddamn gun. They're coming.
That's not how this goes. Get with the program, Wake.
They're fighting me! There's more flares here. Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming.
Give me the goddamn gun. They're coming.
That's not how this goes. Get with the program, Wake.
Them as long as they keep coming.
Give me the goddamn gun! They're coming!
I mean, that's not how this goes. Get with the program, Wake.
Kidding me?
Let's cut the act now. Where's my wife?
I knew you were gonna say that. I read it all before.
You're a hell of a writer. Congratulations. You're gonna bring about something glorious and terrible once we get you some proper editorial control.
What the hell are you talking about? Where's Alice?
I want the entire manuscript, or she's gonna suffer bad.
You touch her up!
He had Alice, and he wanted the manuscript because he thought it held some magical power. But I had no manuscript to give him. I had to get back to Barry and figure out my next move.
Barry. Make it through the woods, bro. Thank you.
I had heard the plane fall. It made no sense. It was clear that it had just fallen here, but it was very old and obviously hadn't flown in decades. Looking at it sent a shiver down my spine.
Thank you.
gotta reach the top.
Thank you.
don't be greedy, but I think we should use the shotgun. The big boss type of guys.
Be aware of Widowmakers!
torres. No bitches. Light, the almighty light. Run, bro, run, run, run. Run to the light. Thank God, call me.
Barry?
Ow! The porch is covered with birds. They've got all Hitchcock on me.
Stay out of sight. I'm on my way. Don't open the door.
What, am I crazy?
Stay hidden. I'll be there soon. Just make sure you keep the lights on. I still had to reach Barry at the cabin, but at least I was out of the woods. To get the car from the locked garage. It would get me back to Barry faster, and the headlights were a welcome bonus.
Yes, 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 that's true. How do you find garage keys? Right.
had to find the key to the garage.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
I needed the garage key to get to the car.
A story is not a machine that does what you tell it. A story is a beast with a life of its own. Okay. You can create it, shape it, but as the story grows, it starts wanting things of its own. Change one thing and you set off a chain reaction of events that spreads through the whole thing. The characters have to be true to themselves. The events need to follow a logic that fits the story. A single flaw and the magic is gone. The story dies. Alice dies.
Behind the abyss path for Eden Head.
Thank you.
It was the kidnapper.
You son of a bitch! Where's my wife?
Enough horseplay, wake! You deliver the manuscript, and you can have your woman back. Simple as that.
I don't... Listen. Listen. I'm gonna need time to finish it. I still need to write the ending. I need... a week.
It's not done?
I need a week.
2 days! The old Bright Falls coal mine is nearby. You can find it easy, city boy. The main building, there at noon. You bring the manuscript, you'll get your wife. If not, well, get me.
Yes, yes, I get you.
Failed successfully. No, why?
Barry had talked about birds over the phone.
Got in here before I blocked the chimney. This isn't normal. These birds are
open the door now. They're gone.
Hey, Al. I'm sorry for thinking you were having a psychotic episode, man.
I sent Barry to the town to ask around about a man fitting the kidnapper's description. He'd go through the archives of the local paper. Perhaps he could learn something. Anything about the island and the cabin that had disappeared. The man wanted a manuscript. I had to try to write him one to get Alice back. For me, the supernatural had always been nothing but a metaphor for the human psyche, a tool to use in writing fiction. Now, it was happening for real, and I couldn't put a single word on paper.
Barry Wheeler speaking.
This is Rose.
Rose?
I found Mr. Wake's pages.
Oh, you sweet, brilliant girl.
Could you and Mr. Wake come get them? I live in the trailer park outside the town.
We'll be there in less than an hour.
I know.
See you soon.
Have a great day. Hope you come back soon.
Welcome to the Owl Deer Diner.
Good girl.
Okay. That will be it.
And the shadows keep on changing.